Well, it's a blustery night, a Friday night in January, so we must be back at the Majestic. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining us for WellSpan Health Presents Dancing with the Local Stars. And here they are, the 2023 Local Stars and Choreographers, Pete Miele and Denice Staub. Michael Cogliano and Rachel Smith. Lisa Wolkind and Bruce Moore. Jeremy Lusk and Brienna Smith. Yeimi, Bautista and Frank Hancock. And please welcome our judges, Ernie Cranius, Dawn Glass, and Jeffrey Gable. Can you make your hands clap for all our dancers and judges? All right, thank you. We are happy you're here tonight. Tonight's couples have been rehearsing for months on end. And they've stuck with it, a little like a marriage, a short one anyway. And they have vowed to have and to hold rehearsals that were sometimes better and sometimes worse. They're richer in aches and pains, poorer after the parking garage, but they've soldiered on in sickness and in WellSpan health. And hope they will always love and cherish their Dancing with the Local Stars experience. They have partnered with, or we have all partnered with a bunch of great sponsors and some fabulous organizations, namely the YWCA of Gettysburg and Adams County, and the Adams County Arts Council. And on behalf of both, I want to offer a huge thank you to the dancers. Another debt of gratitude is owed to our wonderfully generous platinum sponsor, WellSpan Health. Its exceptional support means so much to these organizations. Thank you. How about another round of applause? All right, in case you haven't been to one of these before, or you forgot, I'll refresh you about how this all works. It's not all that complicated, but here's how it goes. For the first number, the couple's dance will be a traditional style, like a foxtrot or rumba. The second dance is freestyle, anything goes. Hold on tight. Who knows what we'll see up there. So watch our dancers, because it's you guys, it's the audience who will be the ultimate judge. And you see the judges over there. You actually will decide who goes home with a trophy. You will vote for your favorite couple using the ballot in your program. These guys will have a lot to say, all right? You'll find that out. But they don't actually get a vote, all right? But they do have some expertise. So you want to make sure you got a program. If you didn't, get one at intermission so you can vote, and we'll collect them after round two, all right? And in our program, we recognize our bronze sponsor, UPMC, and those businesses who are sponsoring the dancers tonight, which we'll talk a little bit more about, and we are so grateful for their support. Now, as I mentioned, to guide you, that's the best way to put it, in your decision-making tonight, we have a distinguished and most qualified panel of judges here tonight. that wasn't even supposed to be a joke.
Experts.
Ernie Cranius, owner of Ernie's Texas Lunch on Chambersburg Street.
Thank you.
Dawn Glass, an accomplished dancer and teacher of dance. And of course, founding executive director of this most glorious Majestic Theater, Mr. Jeffrey Gable. So let's meet these guys. Looks like everybody got a natty light tonight, huh? That's a nice touch.
Yeah. We requested that.
Let's start, Ernie. Let's start Mark. With you. How about we do that? How's okay. everything going?
It's going okay. How about
good,
you?
Good, good, good. Ernie's, of course, and before that, Charlie's, and before that, Ernie's, a longtime landmark in Gettysburg. Everyone might not realize, even though the sign's in the window there, that how long you guys have been at this now.
This year's 102 years. My grandfather opened in 1921. Thank you. At our present location since 1932. And I can go on and on about the history, but there's other things to do next.
Well, speaking of history, a little speaking more history. It was 10 years ago. Like, if this were a ghost story, I could say this very night. But was it 10 years ago? 10 years ago, you were hosting the Dancing with the Local Stars trophy with your choreographer, Bridget Wills. Am I right?
That's right. I forgot about that, Mark. You know, it's funny to bring that up because it completely slipped my mind. And here's the newspaper. This was on the front page of the paper. I don't know. That was backstage. I don't know. And I do remember that we did Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy of Company B. This is the only part of my uniform that still fit. And, other than that, I remember very little about it. We were fortunate enough to come out ahead of Uncle Mo and his choreographer Anna Heckert, and Dave Levan and his choreographer Holly Fox, and Matt Sheeds and his choreographer. I can't read. Dawn, do you remember who that was?
No, don't remember.
Oh, it was Dawn.
That's oh, right. Yeah.
Yes. We came out ahead of Dawn and Matt, and we won the trophy, and that's the end of that story. Thank you.
Thanks,
10 years.
Ernie.
10 years, yes.
Well, congratulations again.
Never underestimate the comedic value of props. So.
One more thing for you on a little bit more of a serious note. You are very much involved in what is known to just about everybody as the LK 5K.
Yes.
You can tell us a little bit what it is and what you do and what it does. Yes. It's a wonderful thing.
The LK 5K is the Linda Cranius Memorial 5K. I lost Linda to cancer in 2014. Luckily, she was here in 2013 to see me win the Dancing with the Local Stars trophy. Thank you. It was the race was actually inspired by a race that was done the year before for a cancer patient named Stacy Hobbs. Her and Linda became pretty good friends, and after we lost Linda, a friend, Lisa Angstad, and her sister Angie asked me if we could do a race in Linda's name. We just finished the ninth running in November, and to date we've raised $175,000 for the Adams Cancer Patient Help Fund, and I think Linda would be very proud of that, and I sure am, and thank you.
Great, thanks, Ernie.
Thank you.
Good evening to you, Dawn.
Good evening.
As we mentioned, Dawn is an accomplished dancer and choreographer. She's worked on Broadway, music videos, television. You are an instructor, an important role in your life. I'm sure you are excited to see our guest tonight from the new Edge Dance Complex.
I am thrilled because the owner of the studio, Brittany Schwartz, very near and dear to my heart. She's a former student of mine, and many of the instructors that she has there that are so incredibly talented, and I'm very proud to say, are former students of mine. And tonight is their debut performance for their brand new studio. They're gonna be here entertaining you tonight, so it is gonna be quite exciting.
All right, another thing to look forward to.
Yes.
Now, before you graciously agreed to become a judge a few years ago, you competed as you guys worked out there. Several times. And you won the trophy.
I did.
With the great Mark Clowney.
Sure did.
And we ask you this question every year, but you've been backstage with the dancer, and of course there are some nerves involved there. What advice can you offer to help them calm down a little bit?
Yeah, well, I know it's a lot. These celebrities have not danced before. This is something new to step into the role of learning two forms of partner dancing. It's a lot. They've worked really hard, but tonight is the night to just let it go, come on the stage, enjoy it, and let this awesome audience cheer you on, because this is what it's all about. You're here to perform and have a great time.
All right. Hope they can remember that. Jeffrey, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
All right. It is great to have you here, as always. And before we go any further, just like to say it is, well, you know, there are a lot of towns that got a, that have got maybe still an old theater with a marquee out front and whatever, but now it's an auto parts store or a vape shop or something. We have, instead, this great and grand and glorious majestic theater, so we thank you for that.
And a really old founding executive director.
You bet, what, 10 years?
20!
All right, I was giving you the benefit of the doubt there.
The college is going to keep me till I get it right.
You have got some real special stuff coming up, though, correct?
Other than this evening, which is always one of the most entertaining and exciting shows all year long, Dancing with the Local Stars. We have coming up, the Majestic is producing the world premiere of the first ever Ken Burns Film Festival right here in little old Gettysburg on February 10th, 11th, and 12th. There will be 35 hours of film screenings and presentations, many of them with Ken Burns himself and his collaborators, taking place in all three theaters. And we have visitors coming from 28 states, from Maine to Florida, from Delaware to California.
That sounds pretty good.
Many of the events are already sold out, but there still are free reservations to some of the screenings available at the box office.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. I do have one final question for you. Among our distinguished panel of judges here, you are the only one that has not actually been involved in the dancing. So the question is, can you dance? I mean, if, not trying to recruit you unless you want to do it next year, but...
Well, when they do the senior geriatric edition, maybe I'll try out for that.
I bet you could do better than that. All right. Okay, well, we will get started. Thank you, judges. Another round of applause for the judges here.
Thank you.
And here we go. Our first couple is Pete Miele and Denice Staub. Let me tell you about them. The Rotary Club of Gettysburg is proud to sponsor one of its members. That's Pete. Since arriving in Gettysburg 10 years ago, Pete has worked his way up the ranks at the Seminary Ridge Museum, a great place, where he is now executive director and also president of the Seminary Ridge Historic Preservation Foundation. He and wife Kara Bainey enjoy camping, hiking, traveling. Pete, a northern New Jersey native, is currently working toward his PhD in American Studies at Penn State Harrisburg. Denice Staub has dedicated much of her life to dance, beginning her training at the School of Music and Dance in Hanover with the Nebula Performing Company. She performed throughout the East Coast while at Penn State. She was a member of the Penn State Lionettes dance team. Denice was a member and instructor at the Salsa Console Dance Company in New Jersey, and locally has taught at the Gettysburg Dance Center and Gettysburg Community Theater. Denice is a financial analyst at Nokia and lives in Gettysburg with her husband Tim and four children. Here are Pete and Denice dancing a waltz to Iris by the Goo Goo Dolls.
To be
of the moment truth in your lies. When everything feels like the movies, yeah, you bleed just to know you're alive. And I don't go home to see me, 'cause I don't think they'd understand. When everything's made to be broken, I just want you to know who I am.
Well, every great lineup needs a great leadoff hitter. A little sports analogy there. Or two leadoff hitters. So congratulations. Well, let me ask you about that. Knowing you're going to be out here first, talk about that. Is that a good thing? Or how do you feel about hitting leadoff?
Lead with the best.
All right. Confidence is good, too. That's good. Denice, you feel good about it?
Absolutely. I'm very proud of his work.
All right, all right. Excellent. Let's talk to our panel here. Are you ready for some expert judgment? I guess I should have said. Start out with Ernie. Ernie, that song, Iris, that was a mega hit in the 90s for the Goo Goo Dolls. Your opinion of Pete's waltz, mega hit?
First of all, yes, hearing a waltz to a traditional dance to a more modern song was really neat. I thought your moves and stuff were everything. And I am a bit of an expert on dance because I don't know if you knew, but I won this contest 10 years ago. So I will lend my expertise. I noticed at the beginning that you started, and then you danced and did some steps, and then you finished. And I was amazed. It was beautiful. It was really, really. And that's my expert opinion of the dance. And I will say the waltz is kind of special to me because it's kind of like my life. One step forward, two steps back. One step forward, two steps back. But in all seriousness, you guys were spectacular. Pete, you were a lot of fun to watch. Thank you.
Don, Pete and Denice chose to do a waltz, of course, as an expert, along with Ernie. What do you look for in a waltz? And did Pete bring it?
Well, absolutely brought it. Denice is incredibly graceful and such a talented choreographer, and she brings the grace to the waltz, which is flowing and intricate arm movements in and out, which can be quite difficult to learn, as I'm sure you are quite aware, right? But it was flawless. And Denice is never easy on her partners with things like this. She is a perfectionist, she's an amazing dancer, and she always brings out that amazing talent in her partner. And she did that for you tonight. That was wonderful.
Jeffrey, did Pete and Denice waltz their collective way into your heart?
Well, even though it wasn't your typical Viennese waltz by Johann Strauss, I thought you danced so elegantly and beautifully together. I think you really enjoyed dancing together. And I must warn you that I had a good friend once who got addicted to waltzing. And to cure him, he had to enter a three-step program. So be careful.
All right. On that note, thank you very much, Pete and Denice. And thank you, judges. Our next couple is Michael Cogliano and Rachel Smith. Michael has lived in Arntsville for 18 years with his wife Carol and their children Patrick, Abby, and Michael. He's stepping out of his comfort zone to have fun, learn a new skill, and make his family smile. Sure they're out there. As a child of the 80s and fan of its music, Michael believes you will enjoy tonight's selections. He's the president of WellSpan Gettysburg Hospital, serves on the Adams County Economic Development Corporation Board, participates in various community organizations, and can be found making fried Oreos on fall Friday nights in the Biglerville Band Booster Fry Trailer. Every organization needs a good fry trailer. WellSpan Health sponsors his performance. Rachel began her training with Gettysburg International Ballet, New York Ballet Institute, and Gettysburg Dance Center, a studio she would later own and operate. She graduated from Shenandoah University with a degree in dance and Pilates certification. After college, Rachel joined Danco II, the acclaimed Philodanco's second company. She has performed in Europe, Asia, and at Disney World. She currently teaches dance and Pilates in the Adams County area. Rachel is a market intelligence coordinator with Open Minds, which is sponsoring her performance tonight. Here is a tango by Michael and Rachel to Vitamin String Quartet's Raiders of the Lost Ark. Thank you, Michael and Rachel. We were talking about this full whip backstage, wonder if it was going to come into play or not. Ask him where he got it. One guess.
Amazon.
Of course. Now that Bob's bullwhip barn is closed up, it's so I imagine you're a big Indiana Jones fan?
I am.
So,
80s.
Yeah, all about the 80s. And you got some good 80s music coming out, too. So, how do you think everything went, Rachel?
Wonderful. Michael has just had a great attitude the whole time, and he's taking everything out of the game.
And did you have to say to him, did he have to say to you, hey, I need to do this Indiana Jones thing? And where were you on that? I mean, did that resonate?
It's been something I've been holding in my back pocket, but it was instantly, yeah, I have to do it.
Great. Well, good job. Let's get some expert opinion here. Dawn, tango with us a little bit.
Okay, well, there's the traditional tango, and then there's the Rachel tango. She always brings a certain something to every routine and every style, and she spices it up. I mean, to give it an Indiana Jones spin, I mean, come on, girl. Every year you bring something new in the props. And Michael, you are amazing. Sinead Turn. In the middle, you gave him a Sinead turn. That little, can you do it again? Let me just see the Sinead. Let me see the Sinead turn. Yes! I love it. That was phenomenal. And it was such a unique take on the tango and very entertaining. Audience, would you agree? Great job.
Good job there, Michael. Last thing I told all these guys was, don't worry, when we do the questions, we won't put you on the spot. But
you're welcome.
Knock that out. It was great. Sinead Turn, right?
That's right.
Awesome. Jeffrey, nobody knows, maybe you do, but whether Harrison Ford can dance or not, but of course, maybe he can't. But when you think, or you hear that theme, which we all know, are you going to be thinking of these guys now?
Yes. And as a judge, I need to be fair and impartial. So full disclosure to the audience that Michael is the president of WellSpan Gettysburg Hospital, who donates generously to the Majestic Endowment. So I need to be brutally honest. You were fabulous. It was an Oscar-winning performance. Oscar-winning. And Michael, you could be have a Hollywood career as a Harrison Ford double.
Ernie, how many fried Oreos would you award Michael for that performance?
I think, first of all, that Tango for Oreos would be a great idea for a game show. Just, that crossed my mind when this question came up. I don't know if you two heard, and I won this contest 10 years ago, and I have a pretty good expertise and a good feel for dance, so I just want to use some of my knowledge to tell you what I thought of your dance. I thought that you were in the back and then you started, and then you danced and did some dance things, and some steps, and then you finished. It was spectacular. It was really, really wonderful. But in all seriousness, your Harrison Ford was spot on, Michael, and I really, really enjoyed it a lot. And I know how hard this is, and I'm really proud of you. Good job.
Judges, thank you. Michael and Rachel, thank you very much. We'll see you a little later on. Next up on our choreographic agenda, we have Lisa Wolkind and Bruce Moore. Lisa is a veterinarian working as a feline exclusive vet. I think that means cats. Who leads a volunteer team assisting with the management of community cats. A former aerobics instructor at the Gettysburg YW and a spin instructor, Lisa is a member of the Healthy Adams County Physical Task Force. She came here back in 2005, expecting it to be a short-term stay. But after falling in love with the area and her late husband, Scott Weybrand, she planted roots. Through the years, and now while traversing a period of grief, Lisa has made the YW a second home. Her sponsors are her colleagues at Confederate Woods Veterinary Hospital, Gettysburg Animal Hospital, Littlestown Veterinary Hospital, and Frederick Cat Vet. Bruce has performed on and off Broadway in Disney animated features, national tours, and regional theaters across the U.S. His Broadway debut was in Gypsy, starring Tyne Daly. Other Broadway credits include Richard Chamberlain's My Fair Lady as understudy to the part of Freddie. In the musical Grease, he played multiple roles and an ensemble member who backed up a rotating cavalcade of stars featuring, get this, Xena warrior Princess Lucy Lawless, to the Exorcist's own Linda Blair. Recently, Bruce was the understudy to Billy Porter, the Emmy-winning best actor in a drama series for Pose. In his spare time, Bruce teaches tap, dedicating their dance to everyone who is missing someone tonight. Lisa Wolkind and Bruce Moore perform the nightclub two-step to Caitlin and Will's Address in the Stars.
There are stars up above, so far away, we only see their light long, long after the star itself is gone. And so it is with people we have loved. Their memories keep shining ever brightly, though their time with us is done. But the stars that light up the darkest night, these are the lights that guide us.
I stumbled across your picture today. I could barely breathe. The moment stopped me cold. Grabbed me like a thief. I dialed your number, but you wouldn't be there. Knew the whole time, but it's still not fair. I just wanted to hear your voice. I just needed to hear your voice. What do I do with all I need to say? So much I wanna tell you every day. Oh, it breaks my heart. I cry these tears in the dark. There's no address in the
Thank you, Lisa and Bruce. We talked about this a little bit. How you doing?
Good.
Good, good, good. I'll ask Bruce a question. Lisa had definitely some ideas and some thoughts and certainly a lot of emotion figuring out what she wanted to do with this first number. And I just wonder, how was the choir? I know you guys, I happen to be in the same building you're at. I know you worked very hard at it. How did she convey what she wanted to do and how did that go?
Well, Lisa, I would say, is the poster child for hard work and dedication because she was there all the time. I got texts every night and movies showing great step dad. But seriously, she pretty much knew so much of what she wanted to do. So then we put it into dance and sometimes she'd say, well, this looks really good, right? And I said, this is better. But we had a great time.
So you refined it a little bit, but the inspiration came from real feeling.
Yeah, we threw around some songs and really landed on this one. It's the right one.
It seemed to have worked quite well. All right, thank you. Let's see what the judges have to say. Jeffrey, at times you've been considered a bit of a jokester. I'll say that, all right? This number, a bit of a tearjerker. What do you have to say?
Oh, it went straight to my heart. You really put your stamp on that dance. And I loved how you did the two-step all around and took up the whole stage. The two-step is one of the most popular and oldest, most elegant ballroom dancing steps, you know. And you know who also loved the two-step? You don't? Well, let me tell you, it was Lawrence Welk. A lot of people remember the two-step, did it on his big television show all the time. He loved the two-step so much that he named his twin daughters after the two-step. And a one, and a two.
True story.
You're wonderful.
Ernie, your impressions of Lisa Ann and Bruce's dance?
Well, I, of course, very moved by the music and by the emotion of the song and all that. And I don't know if you two are aware, but I won this contest 10 years ago. I don't know. And so I have some expertise and knowledge of dance. And I just want to say what I thought of you two was that I watched as you started, and then you did some dance stuff, and then you did some turns, and then you stopped. It was beautiful. It really was spectacular. And in all seriousness, you touched my heart, and it was beautiful, and I love both you guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Dawn, we've all felt some emotion here. I'm sure you were moved by that performance.
Oh my gosh, yes, it was absolutely stunning. And dance is about the steps, and you had some incredible steps, like that lovely arabesque turn where you turned her was lovely. The lift was stunning. The arm work, the footwork, steps were there, and they were flawless. But you can have great steps, but you have to feel the dance from your heart, and you have to perform it for the audience to connect with you. That's what takes a dance and makes it a performance. And tonight you both took that, and I think you touched everyone's heart in this audience, and we're truly grateful for that. It was beautiful.
Thank you, judges, and thank you, Lisa and Bruce. Our next dance will be Jeremy Lusk and Brienna Smith. The principal of Gettysburg High School, Jeremy Lusk is. He's on stage because he couldn't say no to then Gettysburg Times editor Alex Hayes, who sprang an invitation on him in a very weak moment. It was after a school board meeting, and you know how those can be. With a crazy schedule and a mild injury, Jeremy managed to postpone the inevitable for a year. But here he is answering the call for a great cause. Jeremy's grateful for the support of friends and family, especially wife Renee, who's the only one besides Alex who really worked on getting him to do it. And his children, Aiden, Adeline, Avery, and Arlo. Jeremy's performance is sponsored by AquaVisions. Of course it is. Brianna Smith found her love for dance at 4 years old when she took her first class at, believe it or not, the YWCA of Gettysburg. She also fell in love with gymnastics through the YW's program and was a competitive gymnast with the Hanover Kippers until she was a sophomore in high school. She returned to dance, joining the Gettysburg High School dance team. Brianna went on to dance in college at Marywood University, which gave her the opportunity to perform and choreograph. After college, she returned to Gettysburg, taught at the Gettysburg Dance Center, coached the GHS dance team, and started her photography career. You've probably had your picture already taken by her somewhere along the way. We thank her and Brianna Rochelle Photography for donating her services for our fantastic cast photos tonight. And now, dancing in the Broadway jazz style to Uptown Girl by Billy Joel, here are Jeremy Lusk and Brianna Smith.
She's been living in
I couldn't find him there for a minute. All right, congratulations. You know, we've got a little bit of a different situation here because, Bree, this is your first time as a choreographer. Were you nervous? Did Jeremy have to talk you through it?
No, we were excited.
And this is stepping out of the usual principal's comfort zone, I guess. But principals get involved in some of that crazy dare stuff. Do you ever do a thing where they shaved your head or made you eat a school lunch or something, you know, crazy like that?
I've cut hair. I've wrestled a wrestling coach from 100s. I mean, I pretty much do anything.
All right. That's what we like here at Dancing with the Local Stars. Great job. We go to our panel here. We'll start with Ernie this time. Billy Joel makes us remember that in a previous life, before you won Dancing with the Local Stars, you were known to crush the vocals and do some, you were a bit of a piano man, if you will, with a band called Blue Tonic. All right, so Jeremy crushed this for you here.
You may be right, I may be crazy, but you guys were fantastic. I really enjoyed it. I love that song. I adore Billy Joel. I love what you did to it. I'm not sure if you're aware, but I won this contest 10 years ago. And yeah, there's my...
All right, but, we will go to Dawn, unless you got more.
No, I'm done. I'm done.
Dawn, Broadway jazz, that's a new term for me, maybe for a lot of people. What'd you think? And what is it, first of all?
What you just saw.
Oh, okay.
Amazing. So Broadway jazz can be anything. You go to a Broadway show, you can see any style, you can put it all in. And you put it all in there for him, didn't you? And you rose to the occasion. Let's see, we had a knee slide, push-ups, coffee grinders. That's the thing where he does the leg. Yeah, and a lot of like sass and pizzazz from you, and then some showboat over here. It was pretty amazing. Did you enjoy that, Jeremy? Yeah, did you guys enjoy that? Yeah. That, my friends, is Broadway jazz at its best. Well done.
Thank you, Dawn. Jeffrey, how jazzed were you by that performance?
Well, even though I have never won a dance contest, I know that Brianna, your dancing was fine. And Jeremy, as an Adams County High School principal, I have to give it to you. You are one low-down, uptown boy toy. I give you both jazz hands. Yay!
All right, thank you, judges. Thank you, Bree and Jeremy. We'll see you later. All right. Now for our final couple, Yeimi Bautista and Frank Hancock. Born in Colombia, South America, Yeimi Bautista currently works as Latino health educator for WellSpan Health and Healthy Adams County. She's a volunteer for the Hispanic American Center, Manos Unidas, Family Health Council of Central Pennsylvania, and the Soup Kitchen. In 2022, she received the Lifetime of Peacemaking Award from the Interfaith Center for Peace and Justice. Believing as she does in individual and community well-being, she's an advocate for health equity, common understanding, respectful dialogue, and love and kindness. Yeimi studied finance, earned a master's degree in Spanish and Latin American studies, and is currently working on a master's in clinical counseling. Yeimi is sponsored by WellSpan Health. Frank Hancock, as you'll hear, is a busy guy. He has been teaching dancing in the central Pennsylvania area for well over 20 years. During that time, he and his wife Maureen have taught more than 20,000 dance students. Frank's a retired Army colonel, a retired public school teacher, still referees high school basketball, and teaches history for the Time Traveler's Trunk Company. Currently, he teaches dancing at the Army War College, for the Lures Center at Shippensburg University, Dickinson College, and also in Dillsburg and Chambersburg. And Frank is sponsored by Time Traveler's Chunks. Doing the quick step to Putting on the Ritz by the Philharmonic Wind and Mark Reif Orchestras, here are Yeimi and Frank. Yeimi and Frank, first thing, the beginning. How did you come up with that? How'd you work that out? Who wants to talk?
We're honoring a constant struggle and honoring all the women who live by today for the right.
Awesome.
And so this time frame, 1920, that's when the 19th Amendment and what was going on in the quick step. Was the dance.
Wonderful. Fabulous. Great. Love it. and appropriate here tonight. That's great. Let's go to our experts. Dawn, as our expert on the panel. Sorry, Ernie.
That's right.
How did you judge the pace and form you saw from Frank and Jean?
It was fabulous. Yes, absolutely fabulous. Frank is an authentic choreographer. If it is meant to be in that style of choreography, Frank's gonna put it in there. If it's difficult, he's gonna throw it at his partner, and you rose to the occasion. From the Charleston, every direction change, intricate footwork, all over the place, performance, style, technique, props, it was phenomenal. Great job.
Jeffrey, would you say that Jamie and Frank have taken a quick step toward the trophy?
I think they really got the idea of how to put over it!
Everyone would do that.
You've never seen Young Frankenstein? I won't repeat it.
Ernie.
I'm a little embarrassed. I had a bunch of duck jokes ready because I thought it was the quack step. And then I realized that it was quick step, not quack step. So first of all, seriously, thank you for your service. And thank you for all the wonderful things you do for this community and for the health and welfare of everybody. I think you guys are great. You're probably unaware because you were backstage, but I won this contest 10 years ago. And I just want to use my expertise to tell you that, as I've told some of the others, but you especially, when I watched your dance, I saw you started, and then you did some dance stuff and some turns, and then you stopped. And it was wonderful. It was excellent. But in all seriousness, thank you guys very much. You were great. Thank you.
All right, one more time for Jamie and Frank, and we'll see you in round two. And that does end round one, believe it or not. That went fast, didn't it? Always seems to. Thank you, judges, for your good work. We'll see you again for round two. You can slide out and go over wherever you want to go. And just make sure you come back for round two. We're going to need you. All right? See you in a little bit. Now then, if you did not get in on the 50-50 drawing, you may buy your tickets during the 20-minute intermission, which is coming up shortly. We have a table in the lobby, and we've got volunteers out there. Someone is going to win a nice amount of cash tonight. I mean, there are a lot of people here, and it might as well be you. I mean, honestly, your chances of hitting that Powerball, I don't want to break it to you, just not that good. You know, dancing for fun, for exercise, for the social aspect is a great way to stay active regardless of your age. Helping community members be active and engaged in life are important goals of the YWCA and also the Arts Council. Both organizations offer classes to allow you to be your best self, which may very well have been your resolution for 2023, right? Well, you could make it that tonight. That's a good one. We asked Vanessa Rice, who teaches tap dancing at the Arts Council, if she would do an exhibition here tonight, and she asked if she could bring some friends. And that's how tappers from her classes, colleagues at Gettysburg College, the community theater, and a Zumba instructor at the YW all got together to dance for you tonight. So here are Vanessa Rice, Alyssa Marion, Debbie Williams, Betty Brownlee, Esther Redding, Alexandra Shandon, and Kathy Miller, the sequined sirens. Thank you.
with the three judges for Dancing with the Stars Celebrity Edition here at the Majestic Theater in Gettysburg. And I'm telling you, everyone is loving your comments tonight. We are laughing, crying, loving, and laughing. You three are the best. How many years have you been doing this together?
I write all of Ernie's material.
And I edit all of his material.
Here's something you guys might not know. Ernie has won in the past.
What?
I did. They just reminded me of that tonight.
Yes. He has forgotten this.
Dawn won once too, but she's very modest.
We have another winner. And here's something
and
else.
I'm the loser.
Well, he has not danced yet, but I'm hearing rumors that somebody might get you out there if there's a special edition dance.
Oh, you think so? Okay.
I think so. So this year has been extraordinary, amazing. I'm loving it. We're in the middle, and what is the second half going to bring? What are we going to see?
That's when the competition really, really gets
So it's freestyle, anything they want.
If you think the first half was exciting, buckle your seatbelt because it's about to get 10 times more
exciting.
Everyone
puts on their best game in the second half.
Excellent. Thank you so much. I enjoy your commentary. And we'll see the results later.
Excellent.
Welcome back to Dancing with the Local Stars. Woo. I was a little late getting out here. You gotta excuse me, those sequined sirens were trying to teach me a little tap back there. I didn't take to it too well. But let's have another hand for Vanessa Rice and her friends, shall we? And while we are handing out applause, let's welcome back our judges with a big round of applause for Ernie Cranius, Dawn Glass, and Jeffrey Gable. This, of course, is round two, the final, the no messing around, crunch time, last hurrah, stuff that dreams are made of round. The contestants selected any style for this particular round so they can show off their moves in the best possible light. So, Lord knows what you're gonna see, but it's gonna be good, and it's gonna be memorable. Judges, you up for this?
Oh, yeah.
All right. I feel it getting a little warm in here. I don't know about you. Yeah, it is definitely warmer, and it's going to sizzle even more as Pete Miele and Denice Staub start us off with some hot stuff. We'll be right back. You said it. You said it, Jeffrey. We will start with you.
Well, disco is not dead. Yay. Boy, you are really strutting your stuff. And I'm bedazzled by all the sequins on your costumes. You have more sequins there than George Santo has lies on his resume. Is that a Farrah Fawcett wig? Well, could I borrow it afterwards? You're wonderful.
Dawn, were you transported back?
Loved it. I was waiting for the disco ball to drop down. I mean, it really took us into the disco mode. It was amazing. You kicked off the first half with a bang, but this bar just got raised real high, people, real high. The disco hand, the bump, roll it out, roll it out. Denice, you brought it, the blonde girl, love it. And you really brought it again. You kicked it off. It was awesome. Great job.
Ernie, I can't recall how your band got through the disco era. I don't know if you did any of that stuff or not. But
we actually did. It's a long story.
Okay.
We can discuss it later. Yeah. I tried to moon dance and it was ugly. But I just want to say that I really enjoyed it. First of all, Jeffrey, did you know that hot stuff is faster than cold stuff?
No.
Yeah, you can catch a cold. So anyway, I'm trying to keep up with him. So. You guys were spectacular. It was so much fun to hear a disco song again and to see you guys dance disco. And I thought you did a really, really good job. And I really, really enjoyed it a lot. Thank you so much.
Wonderful job. Pete and Denice, thank you very much. You will recall that Michael had said that he was an 80s guy. Here you go. Dancing to Men Without Hats in their worldwide top 10 80s hit. You remember it. The Safety Dance. Here are Michael Cogliano and Rachel Smith. Haven't heard that one in a while. Sounded good. You guys were great. Let's hear from the judges. Dawn?
Well, first of all, that was incredibly unique and clever. The whole safety dance interpretation. Way to go, Rachel. So creative. And wow, did you guys take us back to the 80s. You brought back MC Hammer. And then what else did we have? We had the sprinkler, we had the snake. You guys, you brought it all back. So fun. You know you were all in the audience going, oh yeah, I did that, I did that, I did that. Uh-huh. It was so creative and so clever and so, so fun. And you did a great job because she threw a lot of stuff at you, but you rose to the occasion and that was good and super fun. Thank you.
Did detect a little hammer time in there.
That's right.
That's good. Ernie.
I just wondered, I used to work in the storeroom at the hospital back years and years and years ago, and I was wondering, I'm going to check, I have friends there. They're probably missing some scrubs. And and I don't know what you're, yeah, I'm not sure if you're, would be keep that quiet, I guess. I really enjoyed watching you guys dance a lot. It's fun to go back to the 80s. Mike, you were amazing. You said in your biography that you can't dance, you can dance. And Rachel, you were a great teacher. You guys were wonderful.
Jeffrey.
Your dancing made me as happy as a chimpanzee with a new banana. And you know, I think you should take that hazmat stripping routine and perform it at Dr. Anthony Fauci's retirement party.
Sounds good. You have to fit that in the schedule. All right. Thank you, Michael and Rachel. We are moving right along here. The second round always seems to go a little faster. I guess the music's a little faster. We're all settled in, but it's exciting. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now dancing to a number from the movie musical, The Greatest Showman. Lisa Wolkind and Bruce Moore invite you to come alive.
You stay that way.
Well, Bruce and Lisa wanted to make sure that we did not forget to pay special thanks to our percussionist, Mr. Ricard Momquist Czar. Thank you. All right, Jeffrey, let's start with you. Did that bring you back alive?
Oh, I'm out of breath watching you. And boy, can't you feel the tension and the pressure mounting on us as judges, each one dance better than the other? I feel like I'm under more pressure than RuPaul's girdle. I owe you $20 for that, Ricky. Thank you.
We should have had him out here the whole night.
Yeah, for Ernie's jokes especially.
Dawn, let's go to you.
Wow, did you ever come alive? Did you bring this place alive? And Bruce, you are a pro. You've been doing this your whole life, and you are quite the performer, and you bring the stage alive. But you brought the stage alive. You are an incredible dancer. You had some flossing in there, saw that in there. But then, you know, there's like really cool, fun dance moves, but then you come up here and you do a fan kick. That's like a technical dance move that you pulled out. I mean, I know Bruce can do it, but girl, you pulled out a fan kick. Like, dancers do fan kicks. You did. I was so impressed. And the drums, so creative to bring that in. And it just really brought the stage alive for sure. So fun. Well done.
Ernie.
Well, I don't want to sound corny, but greatest showman, yes. You were spectacular, Bruce, and you made the greatest showwoman out of this young lady. You guys were spectacular. It was really, really fun to watch. I do have to say, though, you kind of reminded me of Dancing Chickens, because it was poultry in motion. No, I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep up with Jeff. Yeah, where's my rim shot, Rick? Come on. Seriously, you guys were great. I expected nothing less. You guys were spectacular. What fun to watch. Really enjoyed it.
Thanks again, Lisa and Bruce. Thanks, judges. Jeremy Lusk and Bree Smith are about to dance to a Sir Elton John song that could be the hope of all the contestants. I'm Still Standing. Jeremy and Bree.
Thank you.
Wow, there was actual danger of falling there, let alone standing. That was great. Ernie, let you bat lead.
Well, I do want to say, first of all, just some of your moves were amazing, and it reminded me of when I learned the limbo. I bent over backwards to learn that. But seriously, I just think that I was thinking as I was watching you when I might get a chance to see two people dance this way again. I think it's going to be a long, long time. Elton John would be proud of you guys. Thank you guys so much. You were awesome.
Jeffrey, let's go to you.
Well, it was so much fun watching the two of you. And I have to paraphrase Mae West and say, when you are very good, you're good, but when you're bad, you're even better. You were really bad. As in good.
In the good way.
All right, Dawn, a couple of tough acts to follow there.
Wow, I know. How do I top that? So, Jeremy, somebody told me you were a wrestler before. Right, so some people say that... go ahead, yo, let's shout out to the wrestler in the audience. So some people say dance isn't a sport. What do you think, Jeremy? Uh-huh. So what's harder, dance or wrestling? Your dance is the correct answer. Thank you. Yes, yes, yes. I mean, back roll, pirouette, body wave, cartwheel, handstand. Need I go on? I mean, come on, Jeremy. And Bree, girl, you gave it to him. I'm sorry, what'd you say was the harder sport? Thank you. I'm actually not sure how you are still standing after that, because wow, 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 what an amazing performance. Well done.
All right, thank you again, Jeremy and Bree. Thank you, judges. Keep walking here, over here thinking, where's my podium? I'll be all right. All righty, now dancing to a medley of Volare by Gypsy Kings and the smash hit, We Don't Talk About Bruno, from the Oscar-winning Disney animation movie Encanto, are Jaime Bautista and Frank Hancock.
We don't talk about Bruno, no, 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 no. We don't talk.
Wonderful. I'm going to have to start with you, Jeffrey, because I thought for a minute there you were going to come out of your chair.
You guys are hot. Your buns were so hot, you'd win first place in the Pennsylvania Farm Show Bake Off.
Who wants to try to top that? Ernie.
Well, I just want everyone to know, you need to take, I've always learned to take what Jeffrey says with a grain of salt, and a slice of lime, and a shot of tequila. I do want to say, Jeimi, I've known you for a long time from working at WellSpan, and wow, you're spectacular, and your dancing was spectacular, you look spectacular, you guys were just wonderful. I really, Frank, you bring out the best in everyone you've danced with. I've been here for a few years and watched your work, and you are amazing, and you guys were really, really great. Thank you so much.
John, let me ask you about the staging of all this and working all that stuff out. I mean, that's
okay. Yeah, the setup was spectacular. Frank, you're so creative. You really just bring it every year, and you just really bring the audience into an experience, not just a dance. Very creative, incredibly clever. And now let's talk about you, hot stuff. Okay, so the salsa is a difficult dance from the standpoint of footwork and intricate arm work. But you can do the salsa as a dance, but you, my lady, did the salsa as a hot, sassy performer. Because your arms and the way your body moved, you are made to salsa. That was so amazing. That was spectacular. That was spectacular. That's how it's done. Great job.
All right, thank you. Frank and Jeimi, very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wonderful. And that just about does it for round two. We've got some other stuff coming up, but let me just say a big thank you to this esteemed panel here. You have given the audience plenty to remember and a lot of jokes they'd like to forget. Probably can't. So let's hear it for Ernie, for Dawn, for Jeffrey. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, if you've seen this show before, you know we feature young dancers from the community, right? And as you heard early on tonight, we talked to Dawn about it just a little bit. Most of our choreographers started dancing at a very early age. Having that instruction available makes all the difference. The Edge Dance Complex is South Central Pennsylvania's newest dance studio, offering prestige training for dancers of all ages and abilities in many genres: ballet, jazz, musical theater, acrobatics, and tap, to name just a few. With more than 25 years of experience and knowledge, the professional staff has been developing generations of dancers with distinctive talent and skill while maintaining a fun, family-oriented environment. Can't ask for more than that. The faculty's extraordinary knowledge of the industry, personal experiences, and passion for the arts create the perfect recipe for students to achieve the same remarkable accomplishments and experiences throughout their dance journey, wherever that may go. So here then, in its first public appearance on any stage, we are thrilled to introduce the Edge Dance Complex Performing Company.
Like a force of nature, no stopping now. wanted to stay, but I couldn't look at you, cause that look on your face, it just told me that you made a mistake, that I just have to get out now. You cried to me, said you need to tell me something, said you couldn't breathe, cause you did a stupid thing that you didn't mean, said hear me out before you go. Then you told me that you kissed and now it's all gone wrong. So tell me how you kissed and tell me how long. So I'm about to leave, I'm about to leave, I'm about to leave, cause I give my heart to you. I really hate the thought of him all over you, in front of everybody, and now I'm the fool. I wish I could forgive, but it's broken, cause I give my heart. I give my heart to you. I really never thought it's something you would do, in front of everybody, and now I'm the fool. I wish I could forgive, but it's broken. It's broken. Underneath your breath,
Oh,
Wow, how about that? Let's have another round of applause for the Edge Dance Complex. They are under the direction of Brittany Schwartz. Fabulous job. If you have a budding dancer in the family, you can find out more at edgedancecomplex.studio. It's harder than to put all the letters together. Well, we do have a winner. We do have a winner. Ballots have all been canceled. It was close. It always seems to be really close. But before we do that, we do have our reigning Dancing with the Local Stars champion. Chris Lauer is here with us tonight. Where's Chris? He's out. Here he is. How you doing?
I'm doing well.
How has your life changed?
Oh,
I mean, since you won this thing.
Since this, well, it's, yeah, it's changed everything, really. See, like, I go about my life like normal. I do all the normal things, but all the while I get to say that I'm the reigning Dancing with the Little Stars champion.
You know, we've had guys before that won that, you just mention it all the time, so I hope you're being humble about it. Where did you display it? People have put it different places. Not everybody has a restaurant on Chambersburg Street.
It was on display in Waldo's for a little while. And then it might have gotten moved to a back closet for a bit, so I'm sorry, it's like, yeah, that was not smart.
Just for protection, and because, yes, and it'd be a high theft item too, I think. You'd get at least 20, 30 bucks for that on eBay, probably. No, it is really a nice trophy, it truly is. So what you want to do now is just have a couple of moments with it still, because you're about to hand it away. Probably go visit it if you really needed to. But all right, so we are we're gonna meet our contestants one more time before we announce the winner. So let us do that. I do miss my podium just a little bit. Here we go. Let's bring out Pete Miele and Denice Staub. Michael Cogliano and Rachel Smith. Lisa Wolkind and Bruce Moore. Jeremy Lusk and Brienna Smith. And Jamie Bautista and Frank Hancock. I'm going to stroll over here and announce the winner, whereupon Chris will present the trophy to our winner. And if you win, just step forward like we rehearsed it. All right, I just got to see who we got here. Yep, that's it. All right. Here we go. The 2023 Dancing with the Local Stars champions are Jeremy Lusk and Brianna Smith. Thanks to all of our dancers, our judges, everybody that played a part. Thank you for being a fabulous audience. On behalf of the YWCA and the Adams County Arts Council, we thank this great cast again, WellSpan Health, all the sponsors, judges, and the wonderful, majestic tech staff, Jonathan Stiles and Wes Jackson. And our special shout out to community media that always helps us out here tonight too. So, drive safe, and we will see you again next year. All right, thank you.